Good morning, students of class 10. Welcome back to the online classes. Now we are doing the making of a scientist in English, and we are discussing about how Arkwright became a scientist and what qualities he possessed and what method he applied to do his work. So in our previous class we have learned that Arkwright discovered that the gold spot, that ornamental, it looks like other people thought that the gold spots were ornamental, but Arkwright thought that no, it is not, because the professor also told him no, it is not ornamental, it has something to do, it has some purpose. So Arkwright and his friend discovered that the gold spots produces insect hormone. While he was in high school, while he was a junior high school, he discovered that the gold spots of the pupa were actually the storehouse of hormones, or they produce insect hormones. And in our today's class, while in his junior class, junior high school, he discovered the insect hormone. Now as a senior high school student, now he has reached senior classes. As a senior high school student, Arkwright went a step further and did his experiments with the same insect hormone. You see, one discovery leads to another. Similarly, he went a step further doing his experiment. He grew cells from a monarch wing. He took out the cells from the monarch wing and he grew that cell in a culture. He grew cells from a monarch wing in a culture that is called tissue culture, and showed that the cells would divide, the cells, the wing cells, it divided into in that culture, and the cells would divide and develop into a normal wing only if the hormone from the gold spot is used or applied. The cells would develop into normal butterfly wing only if they were fed with the hormone from the gold spot of the pupa. So he went a step further. The first tissue culture, this is called a tissue culture. He took out the cell from the wings of the monarch butterfly and he grew the cell in a culture. He put some hormone from the gold spot there and the cell divided and in formed a full wing of a butterfly. So this was another discovery. So that project won the first place for zoology department, in the zoology department. He won the first prize again. Every time the first prize, he won the first prize. Yeah, he won the first prize. While he was in a junior year in the high school, when he was just fresher, when he entered the seniors classes, he became a new student there. There he also won the first prize because he discovered the insect hormone, that gold spots produces insect hormone. And when he was a senior student in the high school, he developed a wing from the cell of a monarch butterfly. He grew the cell into a butterfly wing after putting the insect hormone from the gold spot in the culture. The cell divided into a monarch's wing, fully wing was grown. So again he won the prize when he was a senior student. So that project won the first place for zoology at the international fair, not in the school but in the international fair. You see that how big the event was, or how big the discovery was. In the international fair he won the first place, first prize in the zoology department. He spent the summer at the Army laboratory. During the summer holidays, he used to spend his time in the laboratory doing experiments. also he went also at the US Department laboratory. He went to the another laboratory. He used to work in two laboratories, one army laboratory and another one agricultural department laboratory. So he went also to the US Department agricultural laboratory, laboratory of the agricultural department. So he used to work in both the laboratories. He was invited, he was allowed to go and did do his experiment there, because he was a very bright student. He discovered many things. So the following summer, again next, the following summer, as a fresh man here at Harvard University, after high school, he finished his high school, he went to the university, Harvard University, and he was a very new student there. As a fresh man in the Harvard University, Albright went back to the laboratory of agriculture and did more work on the hormone from the gold spots. He started working on the hormones. Whatever he has discovered, he worked further. He wanted to find out some more, discover something more. So again he went to the, during the summer, when he was studying in the Harvard University as a freshman, he went to the laboratory of agriculture department and did more work on the hormone, insect hormone from the gold spots, which he had already discovered. Using the laboratory's sophisticated instrument, sophisticated means complicated. Using the sophisticated instrument of the laboratory, he was able to identify the chemical hormones, chemical structure. He was able to find out the chemical structure of the hormones. So, a year and a half later, it took time for him to do some experiments. A year and a half, almost 1.5 years later, Albright got the idea. He got the idea for his new theory. He got the idea for his new theory about cell life, which we were talking about in the beginning. About the cell life. How one cell recognizes another cell. How they communicate. How they reject, how they understand this is not the similar cell, this is another cell, they reject. So in this way, the theory, he got the idea of, for his new theory about cell life. It came while he was looking at the X-ray plate of the chemical structure of the hormone. While he was watching the X-ray plate of the chemical structure of the hormone, he discovered how cell recognizes another cell, how it's all about the theory about cell life. He discovered and he started working further. So you see that one step leads to another step. Similarly, one success leads to another success. So in this way, he proceeded further. He never sat idle. He used his time very wisely. Whenever he was free, he used to go to the laboratory and used to do experiments, find out, did his research work. And he was still working. Now he has got a big project about the theory about the cell life. Now he has to learn about the cells, how they understand or how they recognize other cells. The cell has got DNA, RNA, nucleus, and so many parts. A cell has, he has to study all everything. Now he will study about that and he will discover something new. So that's all for today. We'll meet in the next class and continue about his cell life, how, what things he had discovered after that. We will learn that. Till now, we have two things. In his junior years, during the high school, well, he was a newcomer in the high school, he discovered insect hormone from the gold spot. And when he was a senior student in the high school, he grew the cell in a culture and showed that it was a kind of tissue culture. So he grew the cell in a culture after applying or after feeding that cell with the insect hormone, and the whole wing was grown. That was there. Now here, in the following year, when he entered the Harvard University, he had the chance to study about the theory about cell life. Now you will do further more big project was there coming. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching. We'll meet in the next class.